The hospital, like any other public space, is vulnerable to attacks, you know, and we've seen this happen in other countries, in other places, in Pakistan earlier this year, and in Rio de Janeiro. So these are real things that could happen, and especially now with the rise of threat of terrorism, I think it's important for every institution, especially hospitals, to be prepared.
Hospitals, like many other soft targets, like malls, hotels, these places, you don't have armed police guards there 24/7 protecting it. So these are the places that we are worried about, and that we have to increase our defenses to ensure that these places don't come under attack. And if they do, how the people at the hospitals are able to survive an attack.
We take the threat very seriously, and we are very happy to participate in this exercise. Which actually allow us to coordinate our responses together with the police, the civil defense, and you know, the learning lesson as a result of this will be very helpful in terms of honing our plans. We are the first healthcare facility to do so, and what we intend to do is to be able to glean from all this learning exercise, and also to be able to coordinate with the Ministry of Health in terms of our overall preparedness.
We were trained, and then participating in this exercise, I felt more confident, and then we are actually more prepared to protect ourselves and then to react and help others during this crisis.